a pleasure, as always, speaking about Rail Baltica project, about achievements and about the challenges that lays ahead with the people who are interested in the project, dedicated to the project, and who are already involved or are planning to be involved in the project. During my presentation, I will give you a short perspective from the Latvian side and from Eiropas Dzelzceļa līnijas, who is a national implementing body at Latvia. If you look at the global aspect of the project, then this indeed has been a very interesting and very fruitful year. The project maturity, as we also discussed yesterday, is secured and ensured. We are moving forward with the implementation phases. The major studies are either ongoing or completed. And what is most important is that on every single step in a way, we are looking for this compromise between the global project interests and national interests. And in a project like Rail Baltica, where are three countries involved directly, and Finland and Poland are also joining the project, this is a crucial element to build trust between the parties and to increase the communication. If you look at the national level, then there is no questions in Latvia. The government, the parliament, and the people of Latvia are committed to the project. If we have a pulse, we see that up to 89% of the Latvian public is supporting the Rail Baltica project. Furthermore, with the Rail Baltica project, we will have to overcome a lot of challenges because the project of such a scale haven't done before, and especially with a European railway gauge. So it means that the challenges will be in a legal sense, in a technical sense, in organizational and cooperation. And all those challenges we are ready to face. If we speak more directly about the implementation, we can see that Eiropas Dzelzceļa līnija as well as RB Rail, we have established strong teams. All major procurements under SAFE-1, which is a technical designs, have been launched or will be launched soon. Ongoing territorial planning in Riga and in the rest of the municipalities which Rail Baltica crosses. Especially, I would like to mention today land acquisition. Because, of course, from one side, it's all about the technical design today. From the other hand, land acquisition is a major milestone in a Rail Baltica project. Because only by acquiring land in the name of the state, the technical design can be completed and construction started. So, from Eiropas Dzelzceļa līnijas perspective, as we are responsible for land acquisition, we are starting with the Riga, and more specifically, we are starting with a section at the Rail Baltica Central Station and at the Rail Baltica Station at Airport, as the first financing under SAFE-1 is granted for these two sections. Of course, the rest of that, we are moving in a central section of Riga, Latvia itself, and then to the north and to the east. Just two examples what have been done already. For example, we have established a land acquisition committee. We have signed contracts for land surveying and evaluation. We have established a land acquisition consultation center. Why it's important? Because every single land and every single owner is addressed individually. So it means that we cannot explain, we can explain to the general public the general principles, but at the same time, there are hundreds of questions from the individuals. And it is up to us to give this information as efficient as possible. And this is one of the opportunities to do so. In land acquisition, we have to cooperate with the municipalities. So it means that in case of Riga, we have also established a good cooperation framework. Challenges, and I think that there could be a different global forum about challenges for Rail Baltica project, because they are numerous, including time, financial, legal, administrative. To move forward, the next big thing what we are talking about is the Rail Baltica station at the International Airport Riga. As you all know, the contract has been signed, and on the screen you can see basically the area. It involves 4.4 kilometers, 2.3 kilometers are embankments and overpasses, and however, 2 kilometers are estacades. At the end of the day, contract is signed. The next step is the contract management. which will involve the reception of the building permits and addressing the relevant infrastructure holders for the technical requirements. The challenges mainly are that this is the first European gauge contract for a technical design in Latvia. Furthermore, this is a contract in an urban environment, and to address more challenges, we have to align with the two major projects which are, will be ongoing at the territory of airport as well. First of all, it's a construction of air navigation tower, and secondly, it's a development of airport 6 phase. The biggest procurement and biggest challenge what we have right now is Riga Central Station. First of all, the procurement is announced. We have received 7 international proposals. Evaluation is going on. Secondly, the building permits are received, and technical requirements from 14 different stakeholders also are received. Stakeholder management. This is a big one, because Riga Central Station is located in historical center, and it means that there are a lot of stakeholders. Which actually, I would say it is really, really, you can compare it to the Rail Baltica project itself, so it's kind of a mirror of that. And risk management, all of the risks that you can imagine, they are there. 3 building permits. The blue one is for a new Rail Baltica bridge. Green section is for tracks, 1435 and 5020. Red is for reconstruction of the existing building. It's been said that it is better to one time see than hear 100 times. So we came up with the idea to make a 3D visualization about the vision. What are we planning, how the central station could look? And if I may ask a video. This is a premiere, or maybe a test run, actually, of the video. But it will illustrate what are we aiming for and what is the vision. So it can be truly said that Rail Baltica central station is one of the most complex objects in Latvia, and I would claim to say that in all Baltic states. It is complex not because we are building the station as a building. It is a complex because the Rail Baltica station is located in the historical center of Riga. It is a crossroads of mainly all transport modes that you can imagine. Furthermore, you can have to build station, remove the embankments, put on the estacades, and build a new railway bridge across the river Daugava. Also, what is important, that Riga Central Station is in an urban environment, and the last modifications of the Riga Central Station was 50 years ago. It means that currently, all the infrastructure around the Central Station has developed, and right now we have opportunity and responsibility to integrate all these infrastructures. Right now you are seeing a bridge which is next to the existing railway bridge, one of the UNESCO heritage as well, and not only it will be a railway bridge, it will also bring a possibility for pedestrians to cross it. The complication, just to illustrate, and my colleagues are laughing that I will be able to quote it to my grandchildren, we cannot make a different bridge from the existing one, and we cannot double this bridge. So this challenge from the architectural side is really interesting for a city. As I said, Rail Baltica Central Station, in more ways than one, it's a mirror of the Rail Baltica project itself, because we are removing a bottlenecks, we are increasing the mobility, and we are coming in with a new infrastructure which has never been before. Also, with the removal of embankment, we are making available for the two parts of the city meet. For example, Old Town, which is right now currently very, I would say, nice section, and the second part of the embankment, which is Central Market and Maskavas Priekšpilsēta. A little bit more of the degraded territory right now. So it means, but by the entering Bugatti, it's a nice touch as well, I know. Yeah, I like that especially. So these two parts of the city will be connected. Furthermore, Rail Baltica station itself, Rail Baltica comes into the existing station with a 1520 gauge. So it means that all the reconstruction works, what you can imagine, have to be without in stopping railway traffic. So it means extensive planning, planning from the construction side and planning from the train operation side. Of course, we cannot stop the city itself. So it means that for a time period what is given for us, it will be quite challenging. The central station itself will, after the reconstruction, will become a multimodal transport hub. Of course, we are not building the city because Rail Baltica, it's a railway project. But the influence and the magnitude of the project is such that there is no possibility for the rest of the infrastructure nodes and city not to adapt to the Rail Baltica and to the changes what Rail Baltica is bringing to their city. Here you can see a potential street view. If you would stay in front of the Ministry of Transport, of course, this is a vision, and we will see at the end of the day how this vision, so the technical design and construction will become a reality. If we speak about station itself, how many of you have been to Riga Central Station recently? Very nice, quite a lot. How many of you have been traveling with the trains? Excellent. So after you all have, what you have been there, you know how the station is looking right now. So it really screams for modifications. Information systems are still from 50s on the idea. So Rail Baltica station itself, at the end of the day, will be example of the modern technologies, example for the people, passengers, safety, information systems, availability, etc. So at the end of the day, when we will look back at the technical design process and construction process, I hope that we will be able to proudly say that price is what we paid and value is what we got. Thank you.